popular elsewhere in the world, and Lux is really strong in solo queue as well. So despite the fact that it is technically the last pick here for Biofrost,
you know, he has want, and it's happening so far.
Exactly. You know, it's all about that push here. And Spica getting on top of him. Phase Rush is proc. Demonte's in trouble here. Oh,
his flash missed. He got the slow. He's getting away. But two more autos just takes one. The
collapsed here. Spica does have his flash.
Burn flash. He flashes, then jumps over. But he'll get a shield and a slow. And Spica doesn't have his jump back. Hey, this is going to be double buffs. Thank you very much. Demonte needs one more spell. Buff transfer complete. Thanks for the cash money. Thank you very much. 300 more gold on the board.
Biofrost, because remember, Biofrost has no cleanse. So if you actually get a stun on him into a binding, he's just going to die.
Binding. Here comes the Q. Here comes a bunch of CC, and there is literally nothing you can do about this one.
Honestly, it makes you more of a spellcaster. It also means if your opponents have a lot of healing and shielding, you can actually still deal damage.
They're the ones really on the offensive here.
Monte not going to find the stun just yet, but that means that the Volibear certainly will, and Bjergsen's days are numbered.
In this game, because they're the ones that are really low on engage. They're the ones that are hurting for the win conditions as far as that is concerned. So the fact that Golden Guardians actually
walks away, not losing too much, saves the warp. You can see Broken Blade is two autos away. Anytime you see the dash, just hey, go into Sanguine Pool, land a couple of spells, and now
he did take. We'll see who gets this smite.
Fight over this one. Herald is going to be stunnable and smiteable, and it's going to go to Spica. Nicely done there. He's going to grab that one, no problem. Brooklyn in the back line. Big shields and FBI going to keep him safe. Knocking it out of Hemo Plague, and how about a re-engage? Is there one? Bjergsen on the side. Ult is going to come across. Damage more towards Broken Blade, but he has a ton of healing and a ton of damage. Haunter is running out of health. And Devilith is on the scoreboard with one. Now the re-engage comes through and they knock down the top laner, but it's a 4v4. Big Q gonna come across, a stun, looking towards Devilith, not gonna catch him yet, but the root! It is a stun, but it's not enough! As Bjergsen cleans up a second kill and a third as well.
Go into the pit to try to take down this Vladimir. TSM wraps around on them with three members and fully commit to the fight. But they do look like they're gonna try to go over and combo it.
Oh, that was a nice one. It's picked
up smaller here, but the dragons that you pick up themselves are worth, you know, some level of intrinsic value. It's, I think, what, four?
Golden Guardians ended up doing this game. And then there's option number two, which is essentially what TSM did. And that is simply seeding the first two dragons and trying to get comps. TP coming in. We'll see if they can find an angle here.
Nice slow. Volibear over the wall. Goodbye to Biofrost. Not really good way out of that one. You are karma.
Gotta be careful. They know that the wraparound is there. So now they will move forward.
And here comes the flat flank. Here comes the big play. Shen ult over the top as well. A lot of burst damage. FBI is trying to run away. Again, the shields are coming in. He's trying to stay alive. Just bear the shields for Hui, and they can't quite kill him. FBI on a sliver of a fraction of a point of health walks away. And now this is a temporary 5v3 as Biofrost rejoins the fray in a second. But a 5v4 can still be tough. The health bars are low on Golden Guardians, and TSM are chasing them out of the jungle.
This is really smart. They're trying to stop them from basing before the dragon. This is exactly what TSM do need to do. If you can keep them around here, they won't be able to reset. But Demonte looking over the wall here for Spica.
And for damage on a Spica, when does he get to ult out? His health bar is a bit low.
There comes the Lux ulti. So this should be a TSM dragon. Really intelligent playing calling to actually just chase them down after that fight.
And that was he wants some magic resist to handle this Vladimir. And the Void Staff is already there for
That's the power of all this AD in the build. Doublelift and Bjergsen are cut off, though.
This is a lot of damage. He's going to flash away, try to stay alive. Fully over the top. Goodbye to Ash. That's a shutdown, and Bjergsen just has absolutely nowhere to go. He's going to walk past the turret. Guarantee the kill for good measure. One more turret shot will kill him. He's always dead. A time to run for an objective.
Going to Golden Guardians, they may just lose the game right off of this. We'll see if TSM can try to put a stop to this Baron attempt.
And they got to make sure Spica can't get in for the smite. He's going to have flash in about 2 seconds. He has smite right now, and they reveal it. They know what kind of health is that. Okay, 6k health. We've got a little bit of time still. He's not hitting. Demonte's not hitting. It's really only one carry dealing damage, but they're zoned out, and look how far back Spica is going. No one's going to try to steal, and look at the Drake timer. 40
happened. Instead, Golden Guardians gets them both. They get the Baron, and they are hunting for the soul.
This is the moment. If Golden Guardians get this Drake, it's almost unlosable. 16. They're diving in for Devilith. They can't quite kill him, but he's at 200 HP. That teamfight's going to be hard. Doesn't have a lot of lifesteal overall, and this build didn't go Ruin King. He's going to try, knock down some of that bottom wave, get a bit of that there. Broken Blade still playing on the flank. He can be the difference maker.
16,
nice,
he has flash. They got to go.
Damage onto Demonte. Here comes the play, and it's going to be claimed. Infernal Soul has been grabbed, and here comes the stun to the front line. Look at the kill up. The eye flashed over the wall. Hedgepicker pops. Broken Blade's in there. A flash shield. Hui tries to keep alive, and he freaking does it. What a team fight.
And now Golden Guardians marching in here with the Baron, with the Soul. They have taken full control of this game. They're going to get mid lane inhibitor for sure, and Double may just die.
There is no way to live through this one. Golden Guardians poised to close out the first game of this series.
This
TSM
made them work for it. But Golden Guardians, 4 playoff wins in a row over TSM. This best of 5 puts them 1 away from Worlds as they're going to close down game 1. Still 2 more Nexuses to kill. But Golden Guardians pick up where they left off, destroying TSM on Summoner's Rift.
What an explosive finish here from Golden Guardians. Push here, but you can actually have all-ins against, you know, Bard and Caitlyn. So TSM have navigated themselves into a pretty good...
Cloud Drake will go over. 10% ulti CDR, going to feel real great picked up before Devon has to press R the first time.
Yep, and lose their tower, or they do respond to it and they lose the dragon, but TSM's just going to rush this down. It will be a steal.
Shockwave, it's not going to be the smite in time. Well done to Bjergsen. He might have been comfortable now as they've split the drakes pretty equally. Ulti used by Haunt because he's got teammates coming around as well. Broken Blade can't sidestep much. Here comes the rest of the damage. His closer's waiting around in the wings. There's the slow. There is absolutely no way out. A late first blood at 13.
Dragon, so interested to see, you know, does he go for it after 2 items? 1v1 here from Haunter and Bjergsen.
And Bjergsen dodges every single skill shot so far. Haunter's landed the ulti and nothing else. That one's point and click. 0 way to live. Beautiful out of Bjergsen, and now the re-engage could be just as good. No way out for Damante. Even gets the casual extra stun onto Hoovy. TSM taking control on the bottom side and just ties up the gold plus 4 as his turret will fall.
Bjergsen with the outplay there, utilizing the phase rush perfectly to just dodge everything Haunter could do, taking down his former teammate. They get the tower, they get the kill.
The attempt at Rift Herald and TSM looking good in game 2.
They really are. And off of that previous play, because there's no TF ultimate, no Mordekaiser ultimate, Golden Guardians simply don't feel comfortable to actually take a fight at the dragon. You know, it would feel too risky for them at that point. So they tried to make it towards that Ocean Soul. They're the first onto 2 dragons. Oh, nice catch here.
This is big. 2 ultis. Here comes an attempted stun, but Biofrost, if he ever wants to R Flash, could do so. Doesn't go for the play. Just the ward hop is enough. But now a re-engage towards Biofrost. This time they're going to land everything they could want. A single auto finally knocks him down. Double shockwave, and that is who he forced to flash away. Not something he wanted out of that one. Ulti's down, but it doesn't matter. Mid turret's going to fall.
Okay, TSM battling back.
I hear you,
and I think that it's pretty defensible, though, in this situation.
Oh, totally.
It is something that makes sense to talk about. As Haunter, you know, he doesn't want to ult now because he knows he's going to get chased down and killed after it, but he has to use that ult potentially defensively. But QSS is there, so he is just going to be probably gone.
Definitely in a 1v3. Thresh was up here as well. Of course, he instant QSS to knock that one down. So it's just a trade of cooldowns. At the end of the day, it is mid lane pressure. Golden Guardians know they are roughly 3v2 in the set of the map. Arrow's going to land. Here comes the cleanse away, trying to get the damage. Dodges the Q. Speaker's in to block the rest of that one. How about the rest of the knockup? So ulti comes across. They finally get the snipe. FPS going to run out of health, though. Speaker needs 1 more auto attack. He can't reload in time. It's not an automatic shotgun. It's got 2 barrels, but now Bjergsen right behind him. Look for this one as well. That's going to be an easy cleanup. 2 kills picked up, but 2 trails.
But they are creating some space for Damante up on this top side, and we'll see what he can get done with it. But yeah, I mean, I really do like the
knock in the mid lane. No one is here to defend. Tier 2 is gone, and TSM ties the turret score.
The other thing to take note of is the fact that Golden Guardians hasn't had the confidence to team fight at any of the last couple dragons.
Yep.
Does not.
He's joined the roster. He's got more stuff. So now Haunter is in another 1v2. Flashes away from the knockup. Bjergsen runs at 9,000 miles an hour, knocks off the Banshee's Veil, and now slowly walks at him and can't do nearly enough damage. Just for good measure, pops the Seraph's shield. These fights are absolutely not close. So Golden Guardians are going for broke. They're trying to rush down this Baron as fast as possible. Spica is nearby. Bard ult hits. They can run this one down. They can burst it down. They can grab the pickup. They grab the spike. But how about the rest of this fight? How about the rest of the crowd control? Is there a battle to be had in the 5v4? QSS popped to get away from the gold card stun. One kill for a Baron is nice, but guess what? Ocean Drake is alive.
Exactly, and Bjergsen is doing it. So that's 3 uncontested dragons.
Roughly as strong as Ocean Soul. Compositions notwithstanding, obviously relevant here as well. But they've got to get to that point. They have to make that happen and retain that gold lead, or it's not going to matter anymore.
Oh.
Great Bard ult is going to stop the first engage. But is there a fight they can have? Spica healing up on the minion wave, right? The Ocean Soul doing some dividends, getting the health bar up. But hey, they are forcing them back. They are dealing enough damage to say, okay, you might regen, but you're helping those picks out in the wings to find the openings there. Red buff being started. It's on some vision. And a nice snipe by FBI is going to grab the red buff. He's got to get the Mikhail's. The Claim's got to flash away. Stays alive. Ulti going to catch Biofrost. And TPs are coming in from all sides. Closer goes for the kick. Catches Biofrost. 1-0. 5v4 the team fight. How good is it going to look? A double knockdown for Broken Blade. And Closer forced away as well. Hoohee low on health. Haunter pulled into the Death Realm with the Broken Blade here as well. A snipe on Dilquan's been half HP. FBI maybe can be the carry. More damage on Broken Blade, but the cleanse, the Mikhail's all
Guardians, the gold lead slightly pads in their favor, but Bjergsen's still a gigantic threat. Lost the Banshee's Veil. Ulti's gonna land. Again, they've gotta find the play. They've gotta find the CC. They gotta find the stun. The kick gets him over the wall. They're gonna chase it down though, and that's gonna be the shutdown. The damage was there, and it's time to chase on down. Without Bjergsen, this fight is a lot easier. Doublelift burns the QSS, flashes away from Hanser. Knockup engages there. He's gonna pull the ulti into Broken Blade. They're gonna fight 1v1 as Speak is forced to run backwards. Easy scuttle take here for TSM, but it's gonna be Golden Guardians who want to chase. Speak at 200 health, flashes over the wall, and there is no contest here for the Elder Dragon. Speak is trying to regen up. He gets a lot. Ocean Drake plus hitting jungle monsters, but it is a 5v4. Bjergsen cannot be in this fight, and they cannot steal the Elder Dragon. So Golden Guardians again find the pick they need. The
killing off Bjergsen. And that gives them the Elder. The Elder gives them the
fear. It is time to kill the base. You are never going to be more power spiked than this. Bifrost tries to find the hook. Can't find it just yet. This turret is gone. How many inhibs will they get? Can they reach the Nexus? Top lane turret going to fall as well. Double inhib is a guarantee. Still 54 seconds on Elder and Doublelift. Gets a nice shield from Orianna. Means he barely feels the ulti out from Caitlyn. Bot wave not anywhere close. They're going for the Nexus on this. TSM must mount the defense on these turrets. Top lane under fire. Fall somewhat near where the siege would be. They keep spreading around. Looking to knock down the waves back and forth. Double cannon wave is in. Bjergsen knocks them down a bit. Two autos will kill that one off. Banshee's Veil not yet knocked off Bjergsen. He is still not a target. One auto will knock down that top turret. Rapid fire cannon does do its worth in gold when you need little pot shots to knock those turrets down. Double does the best to wave clear. Gets a little bit of poke on FBI. Elder buff gone in 15 seconds. That is most of the combat power that Golden Guardians have. They walk in the next wave. They are not outing the top turret just yet, but they really need to put a couple of shots in. Bot lane taking some damage. Couple of cannon minions there as well. A little bit more poke comes in. First turret finally falls. Baron on for 1 minute here as the Elder falls off. Golden Guardians go for the ulti. They get two. They get two. Here comes the engage. And they're going to pull back. Doublelift and flashless. He will die. A stopwatch. Azonius keeps Devontae alive. The second turret is now gone as well. And they've pulled in the fight. They've looked for the kill. Broken Blade burns the QSS. The Nexus is falling. And Golden Guardians 2-0 in the best of five.
Oh my god. Who really care about it at all is going to be from Senna. That's easily answerable by your Counter-Strike. So I do think that your itemization becomes incredibly simple this game. You know, four Broken Blade.
The jungler was known to be topside with the Herald take. Decent damage towards Doublelift here. Second plate is claimed. And that is an ulti onto
Hoomy.
That is a lot of damage available. The flash engage. They're going for double, forcing the flash away to keep him alive. But Bowercross right over the wall, finding a stun here towards Closer. He can ultimate when he needs to and does so, but the rest of the squad is still on the chase. Looking for another stun. A dunk backwards. They're going to grab first blood.
Speaking for TSM, as Doublelift tries to bait in, and there's the play towards FBI. Not going to be stunned, but Bowercross is certainly going to be rooted. Herald summons, but it might not get too much done. Actually, let's answer this one as FBI has to cleanse away. And this wave is definitely getting shoved in. Bit of damage for Doublelift, but this turret needs a lot of health right now. TP play comes in, root towards Bjergsen. Decent damage dealt, forced to flash away. As there's one kill for Demonte, gets a shield and wants to keep going.
Out-traded by the Golden Guardians bottom lane, despite having the numbers advantage. And because of that huge HP advantage, they're now going to try to go for FBI. No
big
play.
Shuffle. FBI flash to stay alive. That's going to be a nice ulti for Biofrost. Is there a re-engage? Speaker wants in, dunks him right back. That's going to be almost a kill. But first he kills off Biofrost. And here comes the rest of the squad as Closer also kills Speaker. So it's a 3-1 overall play for Golden Guardians, plus the Drake, plus Demonte wants more. Big Benson gave him trouble, but Tanner Time's gonna push Bjergsen.
Jump, protobelt, Q, really good wave clear there, and Bjergsen will at least answer the bottom turret. That's first turret of the game.
Well,
knew he was
going
to be safe to do that play. Ulti's traded back and forth, but now health bar's getting a bit low. Bjergsen wants back in. He has the ulti. Not going to go. Now he is. Scoops in three. Look at that play. They're going to get a whole lot done. Two kills picked up. Make it a third. Biofrost will be rooted in place, take a little bit of poke, and now Huhi is going to be a target. This is going to be such an easy kill. Stun's not going to land, but the slow's certainly there. No way out for you. Goodbye. Support is gone just in time for the Drake to spawn.
There's no way you can actually avoid that close range Bard ultimate, so they kill off the support. The Rift Herald charges. They could get two towers right off this push, and TSM opening up a gold lead here, showing signs of life, and it's been so interesting in the CS ones. You know, Huhi notably had been monstrously strong for them, both on the Lux, catching
all of her things at level 3, right? She's already got her ultimate, she's got all of her 3 skills. Like, cool, I shield you, we're good, this is me.
Necessarily, I still think that there is room to go for those types of utility-style items. Third, Bjergsen, though, with the heavy attack speed, 3 soldiers out, they're gonna knock down the tower, and now Demonte in trouble.
Good damage. Demonte gonna have to ult pretty soon, does so, but he's in the middle of literally the entirety of TSM, and Devilish grabs his kill as Vengeance in there. I would say that I don't hate Cleaver because there's an armor stack here, but Bjerg's gonna lose the Banshee's Veil, just gets out of the stun, goes for the backwards shuffle, and Demon can have a hard time catching back up, but he can try. I mean, Bjergsen's ultiless, jumps back to the soldiers, puts a turret down here as well, goes for as much damage as he can, and Demonte, taking too much damage, just has to jump out, doesn't have any MR, doesn't have quite the burst of
Closer,
AP.
Though.
Senna ult finds some damage, Closer wants in, smites, claps, and it took four of them! But they finally find themselves that kill.
Smite, so, you know, that's too risky to try to finish. So Golden Guardians find a really good pick. They grab a tower on the bomb. No exhaust on the Karma this game. So there's no exhaust at all for Golden Guardians, but they're looking for Bjergsen again. And he looks
again
like
again for the
dead.
Play. He has flash. He does burn it. He's trying to get away, but can't get too far. Ulti over the top from a couple of people, and they're going to knock in the mid laner. That is most of the gold gone. So Hanser pulls in the ulti. He's going to catch Doublet. Double's going to have a really hard time kiting a Mordekaiser without anywhere to go. He's stuck in the ring. He's stuck in the circle. Demonte gets him as he comes out of the death realm. And Golden Guardians have found their way into a team fight yet again. They one-shot the captain. This time around, you are not FBI by Alfrost.
Wait, so Golden Guardians looking for this Baron here, and it looks like they're going to get it.
And Demonte is going to be the one to zone out the jungler. Keep Broken Blade away. He's going to run out of health, but not before the Baron dies.
Hoohee
gets chopped down as well, though. TSM. How much can they get? Doublelift has the global ulti available. It's going to be an offensive recall from one. Hanser is alone against four. How many does Golden Guardians lose? They've lost three.
Oh!
They're going to lose a fourth, as well as the arrow from downtown finds Closer. And you may have gotten Baron, but the gold lead's going to go to TSM. Give the kill over a shutdown to Broken Blade.
One champion buffing up the minions nearby. It's as strong as five buffing up the minions, so it does make the siege pretty decent. And so how much can Golden Guardians get?
There's no one answering Broken Blade. So they're actually just trying to trade for this. Bjergsen has Death Gap. They're looking for the dive.
Looking for the hard dive. 5v4. Dunk backwards in from the set. Turret turned off by Bullabear, but it doesn't matter. TP comes in. Here comes Jax. Pulled in the death realm by Hanser. Keeps his backliner alive, but he will lose his life for this play. Cannot fight Broken Blade. He's going to be killed off. And who he is next to fall. TSM have turned it on in game three.
Flash.
If Gozer had flash, right, that was a dead Bjergsen, so he has to preemptively flash. Didn't realize that the man didn't have it. As the third Drake goes over to TSM, one away.
Actually do it. TSM trying to zone and two-man the Baron for now. Jax is on the flank, so they're actually just looking for the fight. Closer into the pit very early, though.
Ults in, didn't have vision, didn't know when it was getting too low, but now the re-engage comes in. Broken Blade wants this one. Flash the rep. Yeah, I can't run the stun, but he gets a slow. Pulled into Death Realm. Baron's not even picked up. Now the other half of the team fight is Demonte. Gets right back to base after his TP comes in. Broken Blade is the target. He is in a 1v4, but he might not be stopped. He is simply too tanky. He walks away, and TSM.
They have got to get a kill here to stop this Baron push. They can't just sit back. Senna does not have the kind of wave clear to get it done.
Spot. This is the time to go. FBI is going to find a route. They're going to find a lot of damage in a Biofrost, but he's going to cleanse. He's going to flash away, and now double lift the target, flashes himself, but Bonte is on the chase.
Oh, no!
And that Tempered Fate will not save his life. That is always your kill. However, turrets are falling. Inhibitor is gone in two different lanes. Nexus turrets falling as well. Golden Guardians must defend 5v4 and make it a 4v4 as instantly Hanser dies. They're going for more. TSM trying to find this win, and they will most certainly do it. As health bars get low, it's kills across the board, and TSM win game three.
TSM staying alive.
The Graves, the Senna, you know, and delete those champions from it. Now that could be very, very powerful.
Okay.
Galio coming through, so that's really more for the pairing with the Leona.
Also go over pretty early on as well. 7:36 is a pretty early timer regardless of TSM getting same, and the entire squad's ready to go for this one. This is going to be a fight really, really soon, and the health bar is getting low on Golden Guardians. Stun the front line. Hoohee is tanky, gets the ulti across to the shield, but he's still running out of health. Finds a slow in a Bjergsen, finds a Galio, but not before First Blood comes through. Smitable grabs the Rift Herald. They're going to grab that one, but first the fight, and Demonte is death number two. So Golden Guardians, at best, are going to get 300 gold for the Rift Herald, but they've lost 900 gold worth of kills.
And they might actually lose more here. Easy spear there for Spica against the wall.
That's another kill picked up. So Golden Guardians falling apart later on in the series.
Essentially a 500 gold swing there. And that is something that is really, really impressive to see. And it does speak to, you know, the knowledge of TSM. On how to extend.
Orianna's here first. This could be a
shockwave.
The first knockup. Hoohee's in the front line. He's tanky enough. The flash away from Closer, but he didn't need to. No one's in range of him. Hoohee in the front. Galio over the top. They find a lot of damage on Renekton, but he is not yet going
shockwave.
Away. Death realm, but it's already too late. One, two, three kills picked up, and Broken Blade's got no problems at all. It's four already. Broken Blade buying some time. Gets the heal. Gets the reinforcements. Gets the shield, and Hanser is going to drop. This is going to be the Bud Lion Ace. Golden Guardian
backline with the ball. Well, they're just focusing down Huhi. He doesn't commit the shockwave early. He knows they don't actually need to.
Carries, you've been mentioning before. Bot lane turret's going to fall likely first here to the credit of TSM.
It's looking pretty dangerous, and we'll see what Golden Guardians can do. They have a lot of playmaking, so that is something working in their line so that the front line is sectioned off and being free-fired on by Doublelift and Speaker and Broken Blade. It gets rough, but they are looking for a pick here now on Broken Blade, and he is looking pretty well wrapped up. So TSM just going to try to trade topside for it.
Send ult to grab some more assist. Really, that is mid lane is going to be held alive, but no one's going to answer topside, so TSM just grow their gold lead.
And Doublelift over a level ahead. You know, he was 10 as a foregone conclusion. They can actually kill it before the charge, and then we're going to have the full HP Herald charge for the mid lane tier 2. So TSM ready for the next fight.
All right, group around the mid lane. Golden Guardians trying to get some gold in their pockets before it's too late. Finally getting their second turret down. Bot lane is
all
low.
Of Golden Guardians is coming down. We'll see if he can possibly escape.
Shouldn't be allowed to live. Sidesteps the ulti. Really good reflexes there, but he's still alone. Going to be under the turret. Pops his own ult. It's going to be Huhi frontlining. He's very, very tanky with F-Shock on. Gets stunned. Should survive the turret shots. I don't think he needed his stopwatch, but he will walk away no problem. End of the day, it's not that much burned. However,
losing everything.
Yes, top lane tier 2 is gone. Mid lane tier 2 is gone. In general, turret kills are worth about a champion kill worth of gold. In map control, they're worth more. So let's look at this one. Okay, two turrets picked up. On the other side, one turret, one kill, and a Drake. That's an okay trade.
Yeah, they're losing.
Get enough vision to face check through all of the Fog of War to look at Baron ever. I feel like TSM might have an easy time doing a Baron setup. TP coming down to the bottom side as Hanser wants to start. The one going against Broken Blade with the reinforce coming soon. Not a lot of good ways out. A flash to get away from the pull, but he's still on top of the enemy squad. And that is a one kill for nothing. TSM might try to re-engage, but that's going to be difficult. Global Sentinel is available.
And Bjergsen is cut off. They're just going to turn on Bjergsen now. He is captured here.
Galio over the top. Flash can't get him away. Shockwave buys a bit of time. And you've got to be kidding. He walks away with his life. Closer's in danger. So is Hanser. A double kill for the Speaker. This is the Nidalee that people were looking for. And it's time for a bit more. TSM walking in now towards who he have felt in Leona. Trying to walk away. Morslow's coming in to taunt. Puts Biofrost sub 15 health. And it will be a kill for Demonte. The re-engage for Spica, the re-engage for Doublelift, and Huhi will lose his life. FBI could be next. He is gone. Golden Guardians base, open up. It's TSM.
Doublelift and Spica just tore through the other side. TSM winning plus everything else. They're looking for the pickup. They've got no flash, and Biofrost could go here. He has his ultimate really soon.
Done on Mort. Mort ult down for a few seconds. It's just back now.
He is looking very good on the Ashe the last couple of games. You know, he is three levels up on FBI. The Senna just isn't working here for the Golden Guardians, and TSM are closing in on this game. Three level 14 characters right here. The highest on Golden Guardians is 12. Look at these guys. They're just heavily outstated purely from the levels.
Everyone's up 1,000 gold except for the supports right here. It's everyone is ahead. Here comes the double slow, not a stun. Now on a Doublelift, looking for the engage, but they don't quite have all of it. Hanser in the back line, looks for Bjergsen and can't do a whole lot. Still trying for Doublelift. They will find that first kill, but Hanser will trade his life. A one for one against Baron is not a bad play, but it's going to be more than that one. There's the knockup. There's the kill. Biofrost loses his life. Shockwave pulls one back in. It's a 3v3. Make it a 3v2. The taunt is not going to mean a lot. Spica's going to stay alive through this one. Demonte is not. There is the ace. A triple kill for Bjergsen. The ace for Broken Blade just 4 minutes after the last one. And TSM are ready to push right in to close out game four. And it's a fast one. We're 24 minutes and 10 seconds in. And TSM are bringing us silver scrapes.
TSM will not go quietly into the night, forcing the game five, challenging Golden Guardians here, and threatening the reverse sweep to keep their world's dreams alive. 7-0-10. Nidalee performance from Spica. 7-0-10.
Plus Ash, you know, yeah, with Pantheon, or even if they went to the Thresh, I think Thresh is great. Like,
sure.
This is a very threatening 2v2. You could easily die. And I love that they didn't overcommit to it. We'll see if Golden Guardians actually do commit to this dive. It looks like they want to. They're TPing in. It's level 2.
The play we saw a game ago. Is it going to be enough for the kill? It is. And Huhi flashed out of turret range. But Closer is on the wrong side of this fight. He's going to be easily claimed. The Lantern.
Oh!
You got to be freaking kidding me. Closer.
It was actually Golden Guardians that had the superior playmaking and the superior execution down the stretch. That's here. More defensive option. Less about the roaming, of course. Does get hooked up.
Merktritz of a bit value here as he flashes over. Could it be enough? Could it be enough? Two more autos. They get the kill picked up. Nicely done. despite the Merc.
Well, it's going to be top lane first turret of the game. The Herald was picked up from top lane pressure, from mid lane pressure, and a lot of money goes over. TSM feeling really comfortable around top side. Golden Guardians feeling comfortable around bottom side. They've knocked some turret plates down. They will get this Drake as well. But top lane is still under fire. No one is bailing out Haunzer. And this turret could fall as well. Plates are still on. Doublelift is in a 1v3. Here comes the bear. He certainly don't care. And Doublelift's health bar is gone. There is no way you should really be there, to be honest. And that's going to be a turret in the top side. A turret in the bottom side. It kills the bot lane. It's objective to the top side.
I mean, it's a gold lead for TSM at the end of the day, but the question is, can you get enough out of your top lane to FBI?
And look what TSM is getting. You know, they're going to walk forward. They're going to land the bomb. This is almost certainly going to be a kill. The bombs are down. Goodbye. Big damage there on the Demonte. Has a lantern, but the bomb is on his head, and he's going to die anyway. And the mid lane turret falls all the same. You may have
Yeah, they're just moving around the map and getting way more. It's like, okay, so we talked about Renekton, he's your super fed player, and Kalista is your super fed player. Kalista is 1v0.
He does not have ulti, so we cannot immune the charge. This will at least deal about 2,500. There's a flash engage towards Bio. The hook is just in time, the flay as well. And a kill on the board, and just in time, because, hey, by the way, it's Drake number 3. Broken Blade has the ulti up in a few seconds, and he's on a flank position. Jungler is alive, Spica is there with a level lead to boot over the opposing jungler. Closer will have his work cut out for him for the smite, but thankfully Kalista's on the board here as well. TSM fighting over wards, but will they fight for the smite? They're gonna try to walk around, Javelin's gonna come in, not gonna be contested. Drake number 3 in for TSM. Be defeated. Now looking at Broken Blade. Now it's the Fed members fighting each other. FBI gonna find a slow, gonna keep going for the auto attacks. But without Rend, it's not the most damage on a low health champion, but the hook is perfect, and the Bard ult only hits.
They get the flash ult and kill off him. Very valuable there. TSM do strike back on the other side of the map, but it is going to be soaking this really strong Renekton. But Purple Blade hasn't based in a long time, it feels like. So I imagine he has more gold than he has spent. But Demonte in trouble.
Finds a stun. They go in for Bjergsen here as well. CC going to come across. Hook's not going to land. Here comes the teleports. Here comes the play. This could be the deciding moment because Dragon Soul could close it out as who he walks in.
Haunzer.
And Haunzer tries for the play. Devil Force to run, but they're going to find 3 stuns. Bjergsen ults himself. How about the re-engage? They force out the Zillion ult. They're going to let him revive. Closer very low, forced to flash away. Can they find the re-engage? Ashley are going to land. Stopwatch buys time. Hook is going to catch Bard. Ulti coming across. They will knock down Bjergsen. 4v5 on the map. FBI low needs to find. Is getting low. Again, Infernal Soul for Golden Guardians. And Spica lands the Javelin. They land. Oh, that is a troll ult. He's going to kill himself before the spike. Biofrost, who are you working for? No way. They chose to do both, and it was catastrophic.
Yeah, that was rough because, I mean, he actually hit the
but there was no vision whatsoever anywhere near the Baron Pit. Thankfully for them, there was a ward that shows 3 of TSM. They know what's happening. They're going for Bjergsen. Here comes the fight. Close are going to kite right back out. They find a hook on a Bard. Not the ideal target, but a big stun means they might force the ulti, and he's not going to revive him. That is a 1-for-0. That is Tempered Fate. And
he's got to get access to something to heal off, and this is going on for a long time.
Mid shoved in. That's going to crash the turret, but Bjergsen gets the turret kill. So now we begin again on the Dragon Dance. And of course, you burn the Elder Soul while hitting the Elder itself, so you don't always get everything you want. There's the flash.
Haunzer has flash. He's coming.
They try to catch him. With Fate's Call, they catch him. This could be the kill, but you got to be careful of the re-engage from Haunzer there as well. Is it going to be enough as the revives come through? Demonte knocks down Bjergsen, and they're going to find a second.
Broken Blade!
So far, Broken Blade running over this game right now. Closer going to be next. He tries to journey away. It's not going to be enough. Dragons.
I think it was an overeager call. They need to go back to this Elder.
Hit the turret at least.
We'll see if they're going to go for it. Yeah, but then you risk the TPs coming through. Haunzer and Demonte both have TP, so they're going to get the tower. They are going to back it off. That seemed like they got a little bit of
calculations. They said we have enough time for the bottom inhibitor turret and enough time for Elder Dragon and TSM. 8,000 health left on this Baron, and it's going down fast. Ash now on 3 items. There's plenty of damage output here. Will they contest? Closer will have to ult in for it, puts a new ward down, and of course he can Lantern out as well. 3k health. Lantern can get vision. They've got to try for this play. They absolutely must, I think, have to try for the steal, and they're trying to bait it around. They're trying to play around the vision. Bard ult comes in! It's gonna be stolen! It's Tatter time!
Frontline healthy.
But they're mispositioned here. They're kind of cut off on the side, the Baron minions. So TSM has got to get back into the base and try to defend this inhibitor tower because it's going to go down so quick. Doublelift on the side, though. He doesn't have his ultimate quite yet.
FBI is getting flanked by Broken Blade.
They gotta CC chain this guy. They gotta do a lot. There's a stopwatcher. There's Tempered Fate building a lot of time, and they're going for Huhi. He could be an easy target. He's stunned up in place, and they can't save him. So back in goes Kennen. Looks for the stun. Looks for Biofrost. One hit would kill him, but he can't die. Broken Blade safe from the side. Broken Blade finds the kill on Demonte, and it's time to run away. The revive on Renekton. Not an easy kill. Speaker.
FBI
wants in, but he runs it down in mid. And gets stunned up and killed. A lantern to buy some safety. It's not gonna be enough. It's two unanswered kills for TSM.
FBI, open up, but this time it's your base as he flashed in, loses the GA, loses his life, and with a 45 second res timer and a teleport coming in from Bjergsen here, they are gonna push in and try to catch Haunzer.
And they might get a lot here. Bjergsen forces out the first flash. They're going to find some bit more damage. Closes in danger. Going to find a stun. Looks for a lantern. Cannot get out. And that might just be the play that closed the playoff loop. TSM ready to push in. They are pushing in forward. 15 seconds. 10 now on Demonte. 20 on FBI. Somehow a 2v5 defense must be the play. And it simply cannot happen. We bid farewell to Golden Guardians, and TSM are just 3 wins away from making it back to Worlds.